First of all, I express my gratitude to Human Resource Development Center, Sagar. I also express my gratitude to the director who has given me this opportunity to present my topic titled as Use of ICT in Academia. Friends, I hope everybody will agree that we are living in a modern world. Without the presence of ICT-oriented things around us, we will not be able to live even for a minute. So whether it is a case with our highly sophisticated smartphone or the kind of electronic gadget that is computer that we are using, or any other digital invention which has taken place in the course of time, I think we cannot isolate ourselves from these things. If at all somebody is very much determined and decided that he is going to get aloof from information, communications, technology, I think the person has to move away from the civilized society to the wildlife. Maybe some of you will have a different opinion in this regard, but presently, our life is totally having a kind of spiral grip around, and that grip is that of information, communications, technology. And since we are the teachers, teaching in the modern world, especially in the 21st century, I think we need to change ourselves. We need to upgrade ourselves, and until and unless we are playing as per the requirements of the 21st century, I think we will not be able to play as per the tunes of the present students also. So this topic is going to let you know about the use of information and communications technology in the classroom. Holistically, it will talk in general about academia, because this will also include the administrative aspects, examinations and evaluation aspects, and mainly it will focus on the use of technology in our classroom. But beforehand, I would like to find out how many of you are using technology in the class, or else you are using the technological equipments for the dissemination of knowledge. Please be interactive. After having a very delicious food, I know that very difficult to concentrate in the afternoon session, but I assure you that we will have a very healthy interaction, and you will definitely learn by the end of this session, right? So please be reciprocal as far as discussions are concerned, and please let me know how many of you are using technological equipments in the classroom for the dissemination of knowledge. Can you share your experience, please? What exactly you are doing, or whatever you are using there?
Actually, in our college, there is smart classroom.
Oh,
very good to teach. So my department is mathematics. So most of all, there are a lot of graphs and animations involved to teach mathematics. So I mostly use information from Boeing as well as YouTube video contents, and moreover, all the PowerPoint presentations and all these things which we explore mathematics geometrically and visually. So I use this smart board techniques, and there also I use Google Groups to communicate with the students so that I can give them as much information as possible.
Good, very nice.
somebody else.
Please.
Yes, sir. मैं हिंदी भाई काफी बोल रहा हूँ तो पहली बात कि तो हम इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी के यूज पढ़ाने के लिए कैसे करते हैं, दूसरी बात की जो दूसरी भाषा के लोग हैं उसके लिए हम इसका यूज कैसे करते हैं।
दैट इज व्हाट यू विल लर्न इन द कोर्स ऑफ दिस।
यस आई नो दैट सर। तो पहली बात कि अमूमन तौर पर हम एक पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन का यूज करते हैं अपनी बातों को क्लियरली रखने के लिए जब आपके पास एक बड़ी क्लास होती है। दूसरी बात कि केवल अब जो है आज के समय में हम लाइब्रेरी विजिट नहीं करते हैं बल्कि क्लासरूम में जो इंफॉर्मेशन अलग अलग वेबसाइट्स पे और कहीं उसे हम दिखाने की कोशिश करते हैं और बच्चों को उस रूप में हम उसे परिचय करवाते हैं। और दूसरा रूप में कहूँ हिंदी फॉर द फॉरेन स्टूडेंट्स आई यूज दैट मेथड टू टीच देम। तो मुझे लगा कि नहीं आप जब इन्होंने कहा कि यूट्यूब है या जब हम हिंदी की बात करते हैं तो हिंदी हम जो विदेशी छात्र उसको मैंने कैसे सिखाया। तो मुझे लगा कि उस वक्त है आपकी जो संस्कृति है आपकी जो सभ्यता है उससे वो पहले नज़दीक आने की कोशिश करते हैं और जब आप उसको उसके नज़दीक लाने की कोशिश करते हैं तो आपको यूट्यूब का सहारा लेना पड़ता है, आपको दिखाना पड़ता है कि ये आपकी भारतीय संस्कृति है। उस भारतीय संस्कृति के पास आकर के वो आपकी भाषा के पास आ जाते हैं जो वो हिंदी सीखना चाहते हैं। तो एज अ हिंदी टीचर आई सी इट्स अ वेरी यूजफुल मेथड फॉर दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर वेरी अनफेमिलियर विद द हिंदी लैंग्वेज। थैंक्स।
Of the 21st century, and that's the reason
that we are capable enough to use the kind of technology available in the sophisticated world for the sake of our students. Please look at this slide. Is it good? This presentation already I saved in the computer, so your convenience you can take it, not an issue at all. Look at this slide. You know, I have identified a few areas, a few arenas of our life that will indicate that the world has really changed. What are these aspects? Number one, the modes of transport. If you see the kind of conveyance that we were using in our childhood, probably the things that we never experienced are now available for all of us. The communication system, I think in our childhood we were not provided with a smartphone like this that we are using, but nowadays we have our own kids, our own children. You know, the moment the child is born, he is exposed with a photograph of his own and then shown to the whole world that the newborn has come to this sophisticated world. Probably the things have really changed. Third, the media. Several changes have taken place. We were used to read the newspapers in our schooling time, but nowadays our new generation is not happy with that. They are, you know, mostly believing on the social media kind of circulation, and sometimes, you know, they get the right information, sometimes they get the wrong information also. Similarly, you have the entertainment. You know, as far as entertainment is concerned, our preferences in our childhood were different. But now, in this world, students of the new generation have their own choice. Shopping, I think the modes of shopping are also changed. Even nowadays, we too go to the shops, we buy, we pay the cash. But now the world has become digital and digital transactions are done, and so many gadgets, so many things you might have even purchased from Amazon, Flipkart or any other platforms which are available over there. Altogether, if you talk about the next one, that is the exposure to technology, I think this is what is going to lead our topic for the further discussion. And the technology has already created a spiral grip around our life. Without technology, we cannot even survive for a single minute. And now the last but not the least that I am going to talk about is the educational system. What about education? When the other arenas of our life are already affected by, are already influenced by the use of technology, how can you keep your academia, how can you keep your classroom away from the influence or the impact of technology? I think we need to really think about it. And just look at this one. It will create a kind of feeling in your mind that in the course of last 2000 years or so, there are a few things that I have identified here that has brought a radical change in our life. The first one, the invention of a paper. That took place long back in China in 105 and Domini. But I think this invention itself was responsible for a sea change to look at the dissemination of knowledge, the sharing of knowledge. But subsequently, straight away you come down to the medieval period. In 1440, what happened in Germany? There was another invention which was helpful to the invention of the first one, that is the invention of paper. We produced a machine that was printing some content on a piece of paper. Long back, the people were writing a script. Suppose Kalidasa wrote Meghadutam, okay, and he wrote somewhere here, just nearby Ramtek, which is located near Nagpur. He wrote Meghadutam, the only script that he wrote. Could he circulate among many number of his disciples or the people, those who want it? No. done. But when this machine came in Germany, I think that was the first attempt that some pamphlets were printed and circulated, some newspapers were printed and circulated, some books were printed and circulated. That was the dissemination of knowledge, and the knowledge was continuously spreading constantly without any break. Again, we come down to another invention in the field of science and technology. That was the invention of the telephone, which took place in 1876. The patent goes to this Alexander Graham Bell, who invented the first ever telephone. That was an outbreaking kind of thing in the world, when the two people living at a far distance, they were literally speaking to each other, getting the real voice effect when they were communicating. I think that was one more thing that has brought the two different people together, and they were not feeling isolated as if they are living away from each other. Then you come down to the most important thing, this kind of thing that came to the world. That is your mobile phone. The credit goes to a couple of people working for Motorola company. Now, I don't know how many of you know about this Motorola company, but you know, this is the company that has invented this kind of gadget, the first handheld mobile phone. It was demonstrated by John and Martin in 1973, and consequently come down to the most important thing in the world that has really brought a radical change in the entire world. And that invention took place in the 19th century in 1833, and later subsequent generation computer came in 1871, and the credit goes to Charles Babbage. Don't you think that whatever we are talking about, I need to say, the information and communication technology, here you have the information. Okay, first it was written on a piece of paper, later on it was printed on a piece of paper. Subsequently, the technology came in the form of printing machine, in the form of a mobile phone, in the form of a telephone, and now in the form of a, you know, smartphone, tablet, computer, whatever gadget, digital gadget that we are using, that has really brought the entire world into a small box called a computer or a laptop. Even your smartphone, once connected with internet, this is also doing the same purpose or working for the same purpose. And this is how the technology has created a spiral grip around everybody. You cannot even imagine your life in the absence of technology. And here we go with the concept of ICT. What is that? Information and communications technology. And now please look at this slide. In the beginning, a couple of slides will try to explain in the theoretical manner what do you mean by ICT. It is an acronym actually. The full form is information and communications technology, right? So what do you mean by this term? This term is really useful, or this term is practically providing you a platform for storing the information, for collecting the information. You can edit it, you can pass it on, and you can use the information for various purposes in your life. Similarly, if you get into, you can use it, even now you can use it, that is Techopedia. Techopedia talks about information and communications technology as if it is going to provide you a kind of tool to all the technologies used to handle the telecommunications, broadcast media, intelligent building management system, audio visual processing, transmission system, network-based control and monitoring functioning and all. These are the technical terms. Already I said, the couple of slides will give you some details about the technicality of this term as such. But as a matter of fact, this technology is really providing you such a fantastic arena that is going to be very much useful if at all you use it effectively in your class. Okay, so when you use technology, you can evaluate information, use it to your own level, either critically or competently, depending on your own ability. Nowadays, we are always crying that the children are hanging up with the mobile and they are being addicted to the mobile. But mind it well, if you divert them for the right action, if you divert them to do something really useful for them, probably the same thing will do really the wonders in life. It depends how do you really encourage your child to use this kind of gadget or any digital gadget in the world. As far as this technology is concerned, this technology is also providing you a very good platform for research, very good platform for knowledge dissemination or sharing, a very good platform for seeking the knowledge from all over the world. If at all I am searching a particular book which is not available in my locality, simply I can log on to the Moscow library or New York library, immediately I will get the soft copy of the book, which may be a very rare one in the world. So that way, the dissemination and sharing of knowledge with the help of technology has really provided a fantastic platform for everybody. And these are the technical issues which are related to it. I am not going to teach you what is technology. I am not going to tell you about information and communications technology in the technological point of view as you are going to learn something in a technological college or an engineering college. My focus is just to use the technology, just to apply the technology in our classroom, and that way only we will focus on. But still, as I have been talking about the expansion of technology, or how the life of an individual is totally under the spiral grip of technology. See, these are the areas which are already 101% occupied by ICT. As I said, like, you cannot live without ICT. These are the areas. One, communication, energy, transport, media, healthcare, defense, regulatory system or agencies. You have banking and finances. And I did not add on education here because I am going to focus on education in particular, and these things you will realize that how this ICT is going to be helpful for us to make your classroom more and more interesting. Already a couple of gentlemen and a gentlewoman said about their own experience. I could do the same thing when I deal with any topic. I am a teacher of English, right? I do teach language, I do teach literature, but when we are using technology in addition to our own direct teaching method, I think that is working as a wonder in the class. I would like to pronounce from this platform that experiment that we did from 2012 to 2016, in a row, our student was standing first in the merit list. In a row, I am saying. Because we have identified that yes, there are a few students, those who are capable enough, but if at all you push them forward and provide them with some sort of technological touch, I think they can really do wonders. So here, you need to understand that, the last 3 points, please focus on that. You need to understand that it is the role of a teacher who can really do wonders in the class. Until and unless you accept that technology can really be used effectively in the class. Second, we need to believe that technology, of course, technology will never replace a teacher. I am going to replace a teacher from the class? Not at all. If you take a feedback from the students, they will say that sometimes you teach better than the technological equipment. It means the presence of an individual called a human being as a teacher cannot be replaced with anything like a sophisticated gadget, electronic gadget. But as a matter of fact, we need to accept that if at all you provide technology along with your human effort, that definitely do some wonders. And finally, we should also believe that the control over the technology, you need to use it in a controlled manner. Sometimes you know what happens, suppose I want to teach them phonetics, okay, Uchchar Shastra as you call it, I want to teach them phonetics. And I have a software that I myself developed. Simply I will ask students, okay students, now you hang up with a computer and learn yourself. Is it really possible? No. When I pronounce a few words, I insist them to repeat after me. I check everybody whether he or she is pronouncing it rightly or not. Or else I record it and again ask them to listen to my pronunciation listen to the recorded pronunciation of a foreigner and then listen to your pronunciation, whether your pronunciation is really affected by your local language or not. That we need to understand, and then we need to put in some efforts to neutralize the accent. Okay, so that way we can do. So nobody is going to replace technology. Okay, so our presence will always be there. But as a matter of fact, see, these are the things that I identify whenever I think about education system in our country. These are the things which are really, you know, creating a kind of alarm in our mind. What are these things? Please read right from the first word till the end. You will realize that I have focused on three important issues here. Number one, I am trying to talk about the kind of place that we have got as a country, we have got in the world. We are the third largest country in the world producing graduates. Number one. Number two, this is a question mark there actually. What is that? Whether we have the industry academia gap or not. Do you agree that whatever we learn, is it of any use when we are placed in the work, especially in the corporate companies? Suppose I am a graduate from commerce, or a graduate from science, or a graduate from the faculty of arts. I am placed by a corporate company, a multinational company. Am I directly useful for them? Whatever skill set, whatever I learn in the course of 15 years or 18 years, whatever education I got, that education is not going to be useful at my work desk. So they send me for a 3 months training or 6 months training. They finish me properly, not finish, not in the sense, okay, finish in the sense they give me some finishing touch as far as skills and requirements are there, and then I become useful for them so that I will be appointed on a certain desk and I will be able to do that task. So here my point is, I am trying to raise that point that there is a gap. What is required for the industry and what we are doing in the classroom. Okay, in the designing of the syllabus, dissemination of knowledge, okay, blah blah blah, so many things, issues or things related to that. Then there is a blockage, sustainable economic growth and quality education. This, please remember one thing, quality education, put a question mark against it, right? Because that will be always helpful to us till end, the last slide that I am going to discuss, because our concern is to improvise the standard of the process of teaching and learning. What is our motto here? Our motto is to use ICT for effective teaching. And when you are effectively teaching, of course, there will be the effective learning from the other side also. Now you see, I have identified a few problems. These are the genuine problems of our higher education. Number one, we keep crying, you know, we keep crying. There is a high ratio of unemployability, high ratio of unemployability. Is this really the fact? Is this really the fact? I will give one statement in this respect. AICTE, All India Council for Technical Education, just like UGC, AICTE is there, those who look after the technological colleges in the country. Okay, nearly 20 lakh engineers we produce every day. That company, that the organization has come to a conclusion after a survey conducted in CERO, S-E-R-O. The result was, or the conclusion was, only 12-15% of engineers produced in India are directly employable. What is the conclusion? Suppose we produce 100 engineers in India, how many of them can be directly recruited? 12-15%. It means out of 100, 12-15 students will be directly employable if it is the case of a professional course like BTech or BE. Now just imagine, some of us or all of us are working in a traditional kind of university or a college where we are teaching to the students of BA become BSc. The stage is already in an alarming position. For faculty of arts, the percent will be hardly 1-3%. For faculty of commerce, it will be around 9-10%. For the faculty of sciences, maybe 1% plus minus here and there. That is the scenario. But what is the fundamental reason behind it? The fundamental reason behind it is the students have the proper, you know, the students have the lack of proper knowledge, number one. You test any student, pick up any student from your class and just check out what is the status of his own information or knowledge or the preparation of his own subjects. Second, lack of necessary skills. Are they skilled? How far they are developing communication skills? How far they are developing professional skills? How far they are developing employability skills? All these to be kept in question. I hope you agree with this statement. If at all you have any disagreement, simply raise your hand so that I will interact with you and we will try to clarify the matter at the same point. Then there is a lack of serious approach. How many students are really having a serious approach in the class? Sometimes, you know, sometimes people will hand up with the mobile. You can't even notice when 120 are sitting in front of you in a compulsory classroom. You cannot have eye upon everybody. Okay? Maybe you throw glances here and there and some take the advantage of that. Right? So here there is a lack of seriousness and then there is a lack of active participation also. So these are the reasons that the employability ratio is going higher and higher. Yes, you have a point.
Sir, one type of problem behind this situation, sir, this, you are focusing on the problem from the student side. But we are actually feeling for this problem for the educational institution side. They are
that is the biggest education.
In the engineering college, only no qualified person are there. B-Tech person has
undergraduate
teaching sometimes. So what kind of
products B-Tech?
What kind of in the क्या सोचते हैं हम क्या बच्चे
सर सर आपने बहुत ही राइट पॉइंट काट दिया है. Same thing I am also going to tell. Okay, these are the points that I identified from the end of the learners, where we find the problem with the learners. And the topic that we have taken up in higher education is the use of ICT for effective teaching. What is the topic today? The use of ICT for effective teaching. When a teacher is effectively standing in the class, automatically he will create a positive influence on the learners. If I myself is not capable enough, how can I influence my learners? If myself is not prepared with my subject, how can I influence my learners? If I am not really good at my own subject, how can I develop the subject of my learners? Is it not a question? And so, you know, in the backdrop, the same point I am trying to raise. And that is the point here.
Infrastructure, they have to also.
Yeah, that is also there, no doubt. If suppose I say like we should use smart class, we should use technology, we should use PowerPoint presentation. In some of the, you know, colleges in the rustic area, these facilities are not known to the faculties because they are not provided at all. So problems are always there.
Absolutely right.
Okay, so these are the assumptions from the general observations. Okay, and when we specify, then we have to take case study of every college independently, because they will have their own problems, they will have their own strengths, they will have their own lacunas, and they will have their own, you know, requirements also. So things will vary, no doubt about it. So secondly, the second point that I am raising is the reasons of system failure. Now it is from our side. We cannot simply blame the students only that they failed to get their plan. We cannot simply blame them that they are not learning. We cannot simply tell them that they are not having serious approach. It is our problem. How is it our problem? Then you see the cumbersome affiliate existing is there. We are bound to follow the affiliated university rules and regulations. You may not like one particular topic. You have a better topic than that. Can you teach it? You cannot teach because you are forced to teach one particular designed curriculum and you remain to be within the particular bondage. So then you don't have a complete freedom as such. Similarly, rigid academic research is there. We have a very rigid approach towards academics and our research activities also. We are very limited to, we are confined to. So that also we need to think of twice. Third, the obligations of subjects. Recently only the CBCE system has come, but otherwise, you know, there was no further scope for the learner to learn. If I want to learn one subject from sciences, one from commerce and third from arts, I should be able to learn. Nowadays it is allowed. But how many colleges are effectively using it? They don't, except the skills course or skill enhancement course. no choice is given to the students as far as the choice of credits and choice of subjects is concerned. So still we are facing this problem. Imbalanced teacher-student ratio, as you are raising this point. Competent teachers are not available because the cream goes to engineering, cream goes to medical, cream goes to UPSC, MPSC examinations or state-run super class one positions. And sometimes, you know, of course, we are really good, no doubt about it. But sometimes, you know, the people get it. कुछ नहीं मिला भाई चलो टीचिंग भी कर लेते हैं. इस तरह का अप्रोच करने वाले भी टीचर आते हैं दुनिया में. तो इससे ये प्रॉब्लम खड़ा हो रहा है. So this sort of attitude is also there from our side, and there is a lack of transparency and innovations and resources. This point I am going to raise actually. When we are trying to insist that we should use technology for effective teaching, it means we need to adopt the innovative techniques of teaching. We know only one teaching method, that a teacher will get into the class, he will have a lecture, the students can see only the face of the teacher, and he will continuously speak for 40, 45 minutes or 50 minutes, the bell rings and the teacher goes off. There is no interaction, there is no discussion, there is no, you know, rapport between the group of the students and the teacher. Okay, then later on the teacher is not at all available, neither in the department nor in the staff room. He disappears forever. So if this scenario takes place, of course we are also equally responsible for that. And the last but not the least, I don't want to discuss on that point, but just take it for granted that the corruption and inferences of politics and all, this is also the basic reason for the failure of the entire system. Now you directly come down to this motto of the entire educational system, as you call it, the goal of education. What is the goal of education? You forget about these points now. What is the goal of education? What was the goal of education, I should ask you? This is the goal that is contemporary. This is the goal which is required in the 21st century. What was the earlier goal of the education? The earlier goal of the education in the 20th century was to achieve first-rate knowledge. What was that? To achieve first-rate knowledge. मतलब हर एक स्टूडेंट ने क्या करना चाहिए? प्रथम दर्जा का ज्ञान अवगत करना चाहिए. That was the goal of education. But is it relevant today? Just I have only tremendous information in my mind. Will it be really effectively useful? I don't think so. Then you are not of the 21st century. These are the goals of the 21st century, mind it well, as far as education is concerned. Number one, building workforce along with ICT skills to handle information and generate knowledge. We should not learn only the knowledge and share the same. We should also be able to generate knowledge, and we should be very good at using information and communication technology, and we should have these skills along with the knowledge that we are learning from different subjects, different topics, whatever the teachers are teaching in the school. Number two, we should be able to enable learners to be knowledgeable and resourceful and enable them to survive in this competitive world. What exactly we are doing? We teach a poem, we teach a lesson, we teach a drama, we teach some component of science, social sciences and all. What else? Are we really making them capable enough to live in the 21st century? I think again there is a question mark. Already I raised the issue that there is a gap between the demands of the industry, demands of the corporate world, and the provision by the academics. Okay, when there is a gap, until and unless you fill up the gap, do you think that the scenario will change? The scene will change? The scene won't change, mind it well. We have to fill this gap, then only the things will improve in the course of time. Similarly, we need to foster the cross-cultural understanding and the peaceful resolution of conflict. Sir has already said that he went abroad and he was teaching Hindi, which is originated in India. He taught Hindi literature, he taught Hindi subject, he taught Hindi language to the foreigners. So beforehand, he has to teach them what is our culture, how is our civilization, how this language came into effect, how the most of the people from this country do speak and love this language, what is the beauty of the language. Until unless he talked about cross-cultural effect, could he really create an influence on the learners? Impossible. So this is how this cross-cultural understanding is also essential. When I learned English, I also try to learn the British culture. When I learn American English, first of all, I should learn the history of America, the American attitude. Then only I can understand the literary creations by the American authors. If you don't learn American literature and American attitude, you cannot understand American literature at all. So this is how this cross-cultural understanding, this cross-cultural teaching, is it really taking place in the class? Except the professional touches that we give them in the professional counseling or soft skills or personal development kind of activities are going on, then only the learners come across this cross-cultural understanding. Actually, cross-cultural understanding is equally required even in our classrooms. Because I belong to one state, you belong to other state, somebody belongs to some other part of the country. Northeast states have their own cultural backup. Central part, that is Madhya Pradesh and adjacent Hindi belt, have their own cultural aspects. When you go to the southern part, that is Saudi states, they have their own culture again. If you go to Kashmir, okay, they have their own culture again. Here itself in our country, we have a number of issues that can be learned, right, to understand each other. So when you compare yourself with the abroad or foreign countries, again the issues are different. So this is how we need to really understand that, and we need to change the goal of teaching or the goal of education. So goal of education is not only to attain the first-hand knowledge of subjects. That is removed now. That is gone back. Here, we need to think on these lines along with the level of knowledge that we secure in the course of time. So these are the issues, problems in education. Earlier also we identified some of the problems. But before you read the points that I mentioned, please look at one particular emoticon that I have added there in the form of an image. Look at the image please and read the image. What did I write there at the bottom? What is wrong with our education system? Now, the answer is there on the top. Please read it. Everybody has to take the same exam. Am I right? We conduct a common exam for everybody. And now the question is, please, what is the question? Please climb that tree. So you have an elephant, you have a bird, you have a fish, you have some other couple of animals. It means this is the variety of student that we get, and we conduct only one examination. How can you address the skill sets of an individual with a common formula like this? Sometimes, you know, in the market, the guides are available. Students go and pick up a guide from the market and they prepare only one answer for any question that comes on the topic. Am I right?
Yes,
sometimes even some teachers are also recommending, okay, whatever comes on the lesson, you write down whatever you know. That is the answer. I think that is really, ridiculous. So here, this point I am trying to raise, and this is also the genuine problem of the entire system. I am not blaming that the system is only wrong. Of course, we are the product of the same system, mind you. We are also the product of the same system, but we put in effort to upgrade our standard. When we put in our sincere effort to upgrade our standard, so now we are tuned to the 21st century requirements. If you don't, then you will be lagging in the world. So now look at that. Academic issues. What are these problems? Issues related to teaching and learning, examination and evaluation, research and publication. These are the purely academic problems. As far as the administrative problems are concerned, problems are there. Because my topic is ICT, use of ICT in academia. Academia doesn't mean only the classroom. I upgraded the topic. I am trying to cover every aspect of an educational institution. Every aspect. Teacher, student, administration, okay, and some other issues which are related to human resource related issues, so that holistically you will understand how this ICT is going to be effective in the classroom, in the administration, and other aspects of the survival of an institution that you call educational institution. What are the problems there? Human resource management, fund management, utilization, transparency, and fairness. This is the, assumption that I take up here when I am talking about the use of ICT in academia. So let us look at it. Yeah,
please. It is an app and as well as this.
Visualize slide.
Visualize slide. Then must take the hand and as well. कि हिंदी में एक उपन्यास है राग दरबारी, आपने नाम सुना होगा, सर शिला सूर ने लिखा था और उसने हमारी शिक्षा व्यवस्था को की पोल खोली है, किस रूप में हमारा मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम काम करता है। और आज की उन्होंने एक बड़े स्टाइल रूप में कहा है, व्यंग रूप में कहा है कि ये जो कोई भी व्यक्ति है वो इतना फ्री है कहने के लिए जो कुछ भी है, जो हमारी व्यवस्थाएं हैं वो आज की शिक्षा व्यवस्था की देन है। वह एक ऐसे रास्ते पर पड़ी हुई कुटिया के समान है, सब कोई लाभ भाग करके आगे चला चले जाना चाहता है। राग दरबारी में श्री राम सिंह कहते हैं, और जब आप यहाँ पे एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव प्रॉब्लम की बात करते हैं, हम जब दोनों को मिला के देखते हैं तो सच है। तो एक बार सब लोग जरा गूगल पे राग दरबारी जरूर देख लीजिए। थैंक यू।
सिचुएशन तो है लेकिन हमें इसमें से ही रास्ता निकालना सही है। कोई भी फिश पानी के बगैर रह नहीं सकती, हम उसी पानी का पार्ट है, फिश की तरह है, वह जीना है उसी में तैरना पड़ेगा, इम्प्रूव करना है उसी में तैरना पड़ेगा, और खुद को बचाना है तो बचाना ही पड़ेगा अपने अपने बलबूते, सही है ना, ताकि बड़ी मछली हमें खाना जा सके तो हमें बचाना ही पड़ेगा। तो हम ही प्रॉब्लम है और हम ही सोल्यूशन देने वाले हैं। तो इसलिए ये सब चीज़ों को अगर आपको लगता होगा कि कुछ निगेटिव लाइन तो नहीं थी सर, नहीं, अगर आपको राम का महत्व मतलब सीखना है तो रावण ने गलत क्या किया बताना पड़ेगा।
दूसरा स्कैप भी है इस चीज का, जो प्रॉब्लम्स का हमारे जैसे आपने बात की थी हायर एजुकेशन की बात कर, चूंकि हम टोटली वेरी फोकस्ड हैं, तो हायर एजुकेशन कम्युनिटीज की बात नहीं कर रहा, चूंकि हम जो सारे डिबेट की उसकी एक खास की बात नहीं है, लेकिन साइंस से आज जिसमें टेक्नोलॉजी में जो पढ़ाई होती है उसको हम लोगों ने बहुत ज़्यादा सस्ता या सबके फ्री कर दिया है। एक्चुअली इसको प्राइस कम्युनिटी बनानी चाहिए, एक्चुअली आप कैपेबल है कि नहीं पढ़ने के लिए। एग्जाम्पल अगर तो यूएस का, तो वहाँ पे किसी भी अगर ग्रेजुएशन के बाद कोई भी अगर आप टेक्निकल डिग्री लेते हैं तो आपको बहुत टफ एग्जाम पास करना होता है। अगर आप यू आर कैपेबल देन यू आर टेकिंग दिस क्लास, बस ये चीज को
उदाहरण देना चाहता हूं। इसमें जो नीट एग्जामिनेशन और जेईई एग्जामिनेशन जी होता है, ऑस्ट्रेलिया के कुछ प्रोफेसर आए थे इंडिया में विजिट के लिए, उन्होंने एआईसीटी को विजिट की, यूजीसी को विजिट की, और जो एनटीए जो है नेशनल टेस्ट एजेंसी है उनके ऑफिस में विजिट की। पता है वो प्रोफेसर ने क्या कहा, एक स्टेटमेंट जो कंक्लूडिंग स्टेटमेंट है प्रोफेसर का, ऑस्ट्रेलिया के प्रोफेसर का, डेवलप्ड कंट्री, उन्होंने ये कहा कि इतनी टफ एग्जामिनेशन जो आप 12वीं पास बच्चों से करवा रहे हो, हमारे यहाँ पीजी होने के बाद भी बच्चे एपीएल भी नहीं कर सके। सी द स्टेटमेंट इटसेल्फ, और हमारे यहाँ ऐसे बच्चे हैं जो 100% नहीं लेते हैं, सही है, हर एक स्टेट से कुछ ना कुछ बच्चे हैं जिन्होंने कितना लिया है 100% लिया है, मतलब अबव 95% वाले है वो, तो परसेंटाइल और परसेंटेज में फर्क होता है, उसका अपना रेशियो है, लेकिन इतनी एबिलिटी हमारे स्टूडेंट्स के पास है, हमें इतनी सारी ताकत होती है ना, पोटेंशियल होता है, सिर्फ इसको एक्सप्लोर करने की जरूरत है ना। तो शायद ये जो नई पीढ़ी है, ये 21st century की जनरेशन जो है, हम कई सारी निगेटिव बातों की तरफ भी ग्रो करते हैं, लेकिन उसमें से हमें पॉजिटिव बहुत कुछ सोचना पड़ता, ढूंढना पड़ता। तो इसमें एकेडमिक का मामला है, एजुकेशन का मामला है, जो हमने पांचवी में मैथमेटिक्स पढ़ा, अगर मेरा बच्चा पांचवी का मेरे सामने बुक लेकर आया तो मैं गारंटी से बोलता हूँ कि मुझे सॉल्व नहीं करना। आप भी एक बार एक्सपीरियंस कर लीजिए, सभी माताओं को तो खासकर एक्सपीरियंस होगा, इतने जेंट्स बच्चों की पढ़ाई में एक बड़ा क्वेश्चन है ना। तो कई सारी चीजें बदल चुकी है क्योंकि नए फॉर्मूलाज आए, नए टेक्निक्स आए, नई तरीके से उनको पढ़ाया गया, हमारे जो सिस्टम थे पढ़ने के वो पूरा एक बार हो ना। तो इस तरह से हमें भी जो है पूरी दुनिया के साथ ट्यून करना पड़ेगा और यहाँ से अपना जो एक्चुअल टॉपिक है वो शुरू होता है। देखिए मेरे सेंटर में किस बार सेंटर में कौन है, टीचर है, एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन है, कहते हैं When we stand in the class, our motive should be that our student or a learner is in the center and rest of the things are just around him. Everything should be targeting the student in order to make him an employable person, a capable person, a learned person, a skilled person, and a knowledgeable person also. So when you create such kind of student, then only you can say that you have justified by getting into the field of academics. So this is just a kind of illustration, I would say, a powerful tool to transform education system, and we are going to use technology, information and communications technology for effective teaching and learning. Let us look at this. What this ICT can really do? It can do wonders. The role of ICT in higher education. Since all of us are the teachers of higher education, that's why I have taken up the issues related to higher education only. If I go to the bottom, that is primary education, secondary education, intermediate education, the problems are different. So I cannot generalize the problems related to school time to the college time. Okay, so my focus is only UGC level or AICT level or higher education in general, right? So let's look at that. ICT can search. How the ICT is really playing a role in our life. So all the arenas, all the aspects are covered in one statement provided in red color there. So ICT can search, research, serve, gather, disseminate, store, retrieve, transmit, receive knowledge easier, cheaper and faster. I think everybody's mobile phone is showing you that you are online. Why? Because your data card is on. Am I right? Earlier, before 3 years or 4 years, your data card was always off. Whenever you are going for some search or some updations, then only for a minute or two, you used to put your data card on, serve the required thing, again hurriedly, you used to, you know, put it off. Am I right? But now, since this 1.5 GB by a particular company is provided in certain 100 or so, now we are 100% online. Correct? So there are some drawbacks and some, you know, some positive things also, but more the positive things, less the good things. So there, anyway, I'm not blaming any company, we are responsible. Who is responsible? We ourselves, the users. So ICT can enhance the quality and accessibility of education. Fundamentally try to understand how this ICT is going to play a certain role in the field of higher education. So it is giving you, or it is enhancing your quality and accessibility of education. Suppose your child is learning, or we are teaching one topic. Do you think that the really serious students are happy with your teaching only? No. They will go to computer, they will go to smartphone, they will search it. Just because, sir, I have requested you, please, after the class, just search for it. So he is trying to create an intuition in your mind that you should really seek certain information about certain things. So that way, this ICT is playing a certain role. Secondly, it is enhancing teaching and learning process. We do teach in the class. If at all somebody is giving a monotonous lecture, so just imagine now, this is switched off. Which one? PowerPoint presentation is switched off. Then I am going to stick up myself. I am a mic pester and I am sticking up to only to the lecture and talking for 2 hours without any interaction with you all. What will happen? What will happen?
Either most of you will be dozing, taking a nap. Otherwise, out of the class. Right, out of the class.
These two possibilities happen. Because you cannot really sustain your strength for 2 hours to listen to a monotonous body lecture. But when it is either it is interactive or else, something or the other that a gentleman is talking on is also flashed on the screen, so you are shifting your focus from person to screen, screen to person, to and fro. This sort of movement is going on, so your body is all other. Right? Don't you think that same thing happens when you are standing in the class for 40 minutes or 50 minutes?
One hour. Now, in CBCS, we have to spend 1 hour per class.
Yeah. In the universities, we have 1 hour class also. For PG, even in the colleges, okay. In our region, you know, 45 minutes, 50 minutes for UG, and for PG, 1 hour lectures. So 1 hour for UG is too much. You know, neurologists say that a learner can focus only for 30 to 40 minutes at a stretch. What is that? 30 to 40 minutes at a stretch. When your students are concentrating on you, focused on you, it means you are a good teacher and you are making learners to focus you for 40 minutes or 45 minutes. If at all it is extending to 40 minutes plus, then there is always a question that what happens in the last 15 minutes or 20 minutes. So God knows, right? If at all you believe in, then you have the enhancing your scholastic performance, as I said. So ICT will definitely, you know, I'll give an example. My child is learning in a technological school, techno school as you call it, right? So he does not carry a huge bag having 25 kg load. He'll simply carry one tablet. And everything is dumped into the tablet in the electronic form. Textbooks, the material, activities, project information, experiments, videos of different personalities on certain topic. So, you know, whenever the teacher is teaching one subject or one lesson, is he simply relying only on the lecture delivered by the teacher? No. So, if he is not convinced, he will come back home, again he will open his tablet, he will go for other video lectures which are available on the same topic delivered by other faculties of the same school organization. So, this sort of thing is there. It means this ICT, don't you think, providing him a better platform that maybe he could not concentrate in one class, but at home he has the facility to look at that. If you go to Europe or America, do you think that the students are forced to come every day to the class? No. The classes are always live. There is a camera, that camera is connected with the website. Website is always available with live lectures, and the student will get one particular code. When he is logging into the website with a code, he will get whichever lecture he wants to listen to. By sitting at his own home, he can listen to the lecture which is presently in one class. And if at all he misses the lecture, same video lecture is available in the video form, automatically received on the website. Later, to your convenience, you can watch the video, you can learn the lecture, or you can listen to the lecture. So this is the sophisticated technology available in the developed countries. But I think we need to wait for some more time so that the things will improve and the platform will be also equally available for all of us. But how is it possible today for an American institute? It is possible because of ICT. So this information and communication technology enhancing the learning environment. So I am giving you the example for this particular thing, that it is equally creating a learning environment and you have the enhancing learning motivation also. So you need not really feel bad. Suppose I dealt with lab exams and SNOSI. I taught this poem in the class written by John Kitts, right? So this video is also available on YouTube. Simply you type that one, lab exams and SNOSI, you will get ample number of video presentations given by, one of them will also be mine. My student can look at that and he can watch the entire video. He will learn as if I am teaching in the classroom. So that effectivity is different. Actual effectivity is different. Which one is much better? We are also teachers. I think teachers' ability directly in the class is much better than just a recorded kind of thing in front of a dummy, in front of a camera, and you teach as if you are a machine. Okay. So these two things are very good about it. But here, this ICT is providing a platform for all the learners. Now please be very particular about it, how really we are using ICT in the higher education. Number one, what are the arenas that we are using? Number one, do you agree that ICT we are using for administration?
Yes.
Of course, our salaries are credited by bank, okay? Our payroll is created out of our thumb impressions or finger impressions. We are monitored with the help of a closed circuit cameras fixed in the campus. Our movements are monitored. So there are so many things that the administrative part is also effectively using. Secondly, you have the use of ICT for academics. Okay, you have the smart classrooms or virtual classrooms, VCR as you call it. Similarly, you can even create the informal groups with the help of ICT. Now we are using social media. Is there anybody sitting here having no WhatsApp account? Everybody has at least one WhatsApp account. Of course, when we are having the smartphone, we have an account, right? Why don't you create one group of your students? This is also ICT. But that is an informal way of communication, and using a Google Classroom, as somebody has said, that is a formal way of classroom. But through WhatsApp also, I create, be a first year WhatsApp group, be a second year WhatsApp group, be a third year WhatsApp group. All the students, those who are studying English optional, they are mainly focused, and I see that how best I can communicate with them, even with this, you know, social media, because they also like it, and I want to do them a proper track that this technology can be effectively used for learning purpose also, than wasting your time, you know, on silly things here and there. So that way, I keep posting them few developments in the language. I keep sending them whatever topic I have teach. Suppose I taught a drama of William Shakespeare. Already I taught, I have shown in the ICT class, full video they have seen for 2 hours plus, but later on same video will also be sent to the WhatsApp group to their convenience. Again they can watch it if at all they want, and they do it mind it well. Because maybe sometimes some scenes they may forget in the class while watching it on the screen like this. But when they watch it at home to their convenience with headphones, probably their understanding, listening to the pronunciation, listening to the standard English, and identifying the language specialities of the author writing in the medieval period, all these things they can monitor. They can monitor to their convenience. So likewise, worksheets are also sent to them. You send them some grammar worksheets or Hindi language, Hindi worksheets, Marathi language, whatever subject you are teaching. So many worksheets are available on your own subject that you keep sending. If you are a teacher of history, why don't you send them the videos of different forts in the country, monuments in the country? There are some video lectures of a renowned professors of the university. Send them. Listen to you. You should listen to yourself first, then you send them the same, then you see how they positively come up, right? So that is also a kind of medium that you can effectively use for sharing your knowledge or enhancing their ability. And this is possible only because of information and communication technology. Similarly, you have ICT for evaluation. You can conduct the live tests, you know. You know that how to conduct a live test? Live chats are there, likewise live tests also can be conducted with the help of such kind of a Google Classroom. You can throw a topic, you can throw a few questions. Students are well connected at their own home. You just tell them, all of you be ready for the Google class at 6 o'clock in the evening. I will be available live. You can conduct it. Very effectively you can conduct it. It means you are using their, not on the campus time, but off the campus time, effectively for the sake of education. So this kind of thing you can do. You can evaluate them. Whatever worksheets you are sending, you will ask them to respond. All these will again come back to your Google Classroom. Then to your convenience, you do it. Otherwise, if at all you could really develop a program for them. As I said, like I developed a software for language learning and communication skills learning. That kind of reciprocal kind of activity can be done. And the system itself will generate an answer sheet, and it will also reflect the scorecard over there. So that way, you, if you have the ability or the resources available, you can do it, and you can use this ICT very effectively, even for the students, and then for their evaluation and conducting exam. When it comes to your personal level, yourself as a teacher, we get into certain research. Okay. And while doing research, may I know which engine you are using generally?
PubMed.
Okay. Which search engine you are using? Many search engines are there.
Google Scholar.
How many of you are using Google?
Google Scholar.
I would like to tell you, when you are doing some research and doing some search for research, never use Google. Always use, as sir has said, Google Scholar. Google Scholar provides you the authentic information. You get the right resource. You get the person who to be credited. Okay? Never go for Google general engine. Generally we search, no? Never go for that. Go for Google Scholar only. Because Google Scholar is also developed by Google itself, no doubt. But that is dedicated for
research only, and the information that you get is provided with the authentic writers. It is rectified and then it is hosted on the website. Okay. But in Google, what happens? Same document you will find by my name, your name, her name, there. Same information will be credited by multiple number of people in Google, general Google. So never go for Google general search. Go for Google Scholar as far as use of ICT for seeking information from internet resources or sources. Please rely always on that. And the last over here, ICT for other purposes also. But altogether, when you look at a particular organization, you have a simple approach that ICT for administration, ICT for academic, that is for classroom, ICT for evaluation, post-teaching sessions, and ICT for personal level at the faculty level, that is ICT for your research, and even for other purposes, we do use it. Because without ICT, you cannot even imagine. Now, we will focus one after the other in detail. Okay, my main focus will be academics, or my main focus will be how to use ICT in the classroom. But parallelly, I will also talk on administration, evaluation, other purposes with a special focus on ICT in the classroom that you call BCR and all. So as far as ICT is concerned, because you know how many of you are heading the department? Okay, some are there. Anybody is a principal or any other authority who is directly into, generally we don't, they don't come for the orientation at all. But as a matter of fact,
there was one person enlisted as principal in this in the list of the candidates.
Oh really?
Yes,
for orientation.
Yes, yeah, but I don't think he's here.
He might not have completed in the first
probably.
So it is left over and he is mandated by the authority to complete it. But it is very, you know, sometimes troublesome to please see it after having such a high profile in the classroom of a orientation class. But anyway, you know, we do circulate circulars, notices, government orders by ICT way. How many of you are getting the printed matters now? We don't. Everybody is having a college group, one or authorized college group. College will keep circulating so many things on the group itself. Okay. So this sort of thing we do in the administration. You have the human resource database as you go for a biometric attendance. I think UGC has suspended it for some time because of this corona effect at all. But still, we are the part and parcel of it. And we do, you know, mention that this is the time that I arrived and this is the time that I am departing. And other database also, salary statements are there. Your total working hours analysis is there to be sent to the higher education department and all. These things are evaluated only with the ICT base. Similarly, finances. Is there anybody now just taking a ledger and writing everything now? No. Our college or every college is having one software. Entire administrative works related to student, faculty, everybody are done with the help of the software only. The moment you enter the name of a student, the entire history, right from his joining to the college till date, will be flashed on the monitor, and in a minute, can come to a conclusion that what are the dues over there or what are the new issues related to the particular student. Everything will be appeared on the monitor. Similarly, online admin system is already there. Everybody is doing that since we are not directly associated with it, but we do take care at least of our students of our own subject, of the subject. So how do you retrieve the information? Do you go to the bundle of the application forms? No. Simply we go to the computer operator who is looking after the admission section. Simply we click there for English, how many are enrolled for optional subject. The moment you go for a search according to the subject per search, immediately you will get a complete list of your mathematics, English, history, whatever you are searching for. That way, this ICT is also helping us. Then, similarly, students and staff, electronic attendance, alumni association, database, security surveillance, SMS alert, and other groups that we create, institutional websites, blogs. How many of you having your own blogs? Anybody has created a blog? That is also the ICT way of teaching. You have created very good. So after going back home, just search blogspot.com. Okay, those who have the Gmail account, you can also create your own blog. Okay, if you want to see my blog, simply type vittalgore@blogspot.com. You will get a lot of information. Blogspot.com. Blogspot.com. You can also create your own profile there. How to use it? You know,
you can create your own blog. And whatever study material, as you are circulating by WhatsApp, you can also do it one thing. Don't limit your knowledge to the students of your own college only. Let it be open. Suppose you have developed some study material on a poem or a lesson or a play or a novel. So keep this one on your blog. What will happen? Anybody in the world who searches under one particular title, suppose Julius Caesar. You know, the moment you search Julius Caesar, out of multi lakhs of documents, a few documents will appear on the board, right? So yours will be also one of them. So this way, at least for your students, you can tell this is my blog, you keep checking it weekly once at least. So whatever possible, I will keep posting it over there. You can do one thing, whatever activities you are doing, departmental activities. Anyway, it will come on the website. But website, college website, everything will not be given. But you can provide all the images, pictures, developments of your own departmental activity on your own blog. So, okay, or else you visit, suppose like me, I visited HRDC as a resource person, one photograph. Okay, HR, visit to HRDC in the capacity of a resource person. Let the whole world know, let my students know. Okay, so this way, whatever that you want, you can share with the students. You can, you know, fix it or you can post it on your blog, and that blog will be another ICT medium for the dissemination of knowledge. Then you have the web portals, web information centers and all. But for a faculty, I would recommend that everyone should have at least one blog, and you can create it very successfully with not a single rupee investment. Do you need to pay anything for that? No. Only have to agree the terms and conditions of Google. I do agree. As usual, we are doing for all, you know, whatever we download in the form of the, you know, what is that? Yeah. Okay. So we do it. Just like that, you do it and you proceed with that. How many have photos?
Can you upload any documents to the blog?
Yes, sir. PDF documents, images, video links. Okay, even YouTube links you can give there. Suppose your document is there on some other website. Suppose you published a paper and paper is there on some other website. So you just take that link and paste the link in your blog.
Suppose for some books which are usually there are a lot of websites from where some their books are available, but they are not available in the general search of the Google. So there may be some legal issues I am asking for that.
Yes, maybe one of my slides will come either today or tomorrow, 100%. Yeah, your pen is absolutely right. You know, the things which are available is your open resources. These things you can paste. These things you can mention. You can keep the link there. But if something which needs certain payment and some issues are there related to the copyright and money making kind of marketing kind of thing, these things you cannot paste it. There is a clear distinction. Suppose I published a book, recently I published it. Till 50 years, it won't come to the open resource kind of thing. Until and unless being the author, I authorize it. Okay, but there is a platform called pdfdrive.com. What is that? pdfdrive.com. For every second, hundreds of books are posted on the website and they are free downloads. pdfdrive.com. In the evening, you see PDF, PDF, D-R-I-V, pdfdrive.com, simple. You will get more than 10 crore books available. For every second, hundreds of books are uploaded by the company. Why? And they are all free downloads. You did not pay a single penny there, not a single paisa there. Free downloads. They are on literature, language, history, anthropology, sciences, technology, mathematics, so on and so on. Any number of subjects offered by UGC, AICT, the books are available. But unfortunately, we people don't know, so we don't use it. Okay? So many books on language and literature, simply I download, I send it to my students. So they did not even buy the book. When they have a smartphone, even in the class, sometimes, you know, if I am carrying my tablet, I will open the book in the tablet. I will teach from the tablet, not from the hard book, right? So I will teach from the tablet. Students are also allowed, those who are carrying their smartphone, they can open the particular page that I am dealing with. So that way also, you yourself also can create the e-way of teaching or sharing the knowledge. So this is very important. Then the ICT for academics, that will be our major focus here. Who is learning? Of course, the learner is learning. Who is teaching? Of course, the teacher is teaching. But my question here is about the competence. My question here is about the competence. And as sir has already pointed out, that there are the people, those who are, you know, qualified on the piece of paper called scorecard. But how far they are competent in the class, that is also a question mark. And there are so many competent people in the market available, not securing a job. They are not securing a job and they are waiting here and there with no work at all. So this is a very critical scenario that we have presently, but we need to accept it without change. We cannot really help them out, or we cannot solve this issue also. Then what is learned? How is it learned? These questions are related to our academic concerns. But as far as academics for competence building is concerned, it is the role of a teacher only. Until and unless you put in your efforts, the things will not change. So sometimes what happens is, when teachers have a very typical selective approach, that I am a faculty member, 18 hours a week or 20 hours a week I am supposed to teach. I will take 3 classes a day. The moment my 3 classes are done, namaste, my job is over. No. If you are having this approach, probably you are not giving more time to your students, right? So if you spend more time on the campus, probably students will also stay back there and they will keep learning more and more from you. Otherwise, I will come at 9, I will go at 2, finish. My 5 hours are completed, my job is done. If this approach is there, changes won't take place. If you want to bring a real change among the learners, spend at least 2 hours a day extra, apart from your regular 5 hours a day teaching or learning there or staying on the campus. If you spend 2 hours a day there, then only the changes will come, and then you can improve their academics for competence building and all. Traditional versus ICT based modern methods of teaching. Already we are familiar with the traditional approach of teaching. Just try to infuse ICT in between. Probably we cannot use it regularly. Some colleges have only one classroom which is ICT class. Only one class. Or a virtual classroom. Only one classroom. We cannot provide every classroom with all these facilities, right? And it is not possible for the institutions also to invest such a huge amount over there. For creating one ICT class or purely your virtual classroom, you need minimum 2 lakhs rupees. So is it possible to every institution to spend 2 lakhs rupees for every classroom? We have 30 classrooms in our college. So 30 into 2 lakhs. Where is the budget? But it's highly possible. But whatever possible, at least weekly once, weekly twice, weekly thrice, try to conduct a class over there in the available facility so that the things will improve in the course of time. How many of you know this NME ICT project? How many of you are familiar with the NME ICT project? NME, National Mission on Education. ICT means Information and Communications Technology. This was a project run by Government of India, MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development. I hope you know that, right? So this NME ICT project, you do one thing now, all of you, you have your smartphone, please, open it. Nobody is getting connection here. Jio, those who are using Jio, along with me, we are studying. Okay, you do one thing then. No problem. You do one thing. After the class, to your convenience, simply go for Swayam. S-W-A-Y-S-E-M. All the video lectures for English subject, 250 lecture video lectures, for every subject, hundreds of video lectures are created, and that was a multi-crore project initiated by Government of India, and that is almost completed. If you search for any subject today, you will definitely get at least 100 video lectures available. Okay? And one thing I would like to pronounce, I happen to be one of the only faculty member from Maharashtra selected for this UGC experts list. And mine are nearly 23 video lectures available on the NME ICT project platform, Swayam, and similarly they are also telecasted on MHRD channel 1. You have, if you have a free dish, only free dish, they will get the access to 32 channels developed by Government of India. Every 30, each of them is dedicated for one subject. Suppose channel 1, only for languages, Hindi, English, Russian, some kind of languages, only channel 1. Likewise, how many channels are there? 32 channels are there, and on a rotation basis, all these 250 lectures per subject, whatever they have created in the course of last 7-8 years or so, these video lectures are telecasted on the television. That is MHRD channel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so many are there. And if at all you have installed this app also, to your convenience, you can go for it, you can watch it out. Swayam, S-W-A-Y-A-M. Even you go to Google, YouTube search. Okay, no. I am talking about Swayam video lectures. Swayam ke MOOC, Amga Maya Shkaya, Ani Wale Iske Bara Me Charcha Hogi. You are talking about a MOOC course, M-O-O-C, online course. Okay, so that we will talk tomorrow. That is a standalone different topic for discussion. And presently I am dealing with video lectures available on a variety of topics. And for every subject they have identified the faculty members from the country. For every subject, hardly 20, 30, 25, not more than 40 faculties were recruited or selected from the entire country.
Yes. How it is possible to show in classroom?
Yes. That you can show even with the help of your mobile. Okay. And if in the classroom, you should have projector, computer with internet. Okay. So maybe later I will give you the link also, or else you can install that a file in your mobile. That app in your mobile, and that also will be very smoothly connected. Since this is not, connectivity is not there, otherwise I would have done that practical here itself. That was in my agenda, so that to break the silence sometimes and to break the monotony also, so we have done it. But anyway, I think this is the time for tea break. So we'll do one thing. Here onwards, we will specifically talk on virtual classroom, VCR. So that VCR is a very unique term and concept, and we need to follow it in our personal classes also. In fact, take a break for 15 minutes, we'll assemble again. Thank you,
sir. Would you repeat the full form of ABT-16?
National Mission on Education. National Mission on Education.
Thank you.
Information and Communications Technology Project.
Sir,
so is it
also conducting online
courses? Yes, sir. We have a special session on it tomorrow. We will see, and I will also request the authority to provide you Wi-Fi here.
Yes.
So that Wi-Fi connection be also.
आज तो नहीं है सर.
कल का जो course है ना online courses का. So ensure that सबको कल Wi-Fi मिलना चाहिए. हाँ. ठीक. You will get Wi-Fi.
सर मैं तो मेरी चल जाएगा. System में है.
Tomorrow we will have the practicals in the class of online courses, and you will get the full connectivity. Okay, come to it. Can we resume now?
Yes, sir.
Lock your ring. So, in the first half of the session, we were talking on this NME and ICT project. Some of you might have served also in the course of this break. But anyway, not a problem at all. To your convenience, please watch some of the videos, and maybe later you will be able to create on your own such kind of ICT based resources for your own students. And later, if at all you post it to the YouTube, let others also utilize the same resources for them. So these are the things, those who are teaching mathematics, MATLAB is there. Somebody said that they got this computer aided language lab in the college or university. Nowadays all these teachers are preparing themselves for the effective use of ICT. Even you will come to know about it, how to use artificial intelligence in the class. I think there is one session on this topic also. So later on you will come to know about it. I will not talk about it. But here our focus is on ICT and the effectivity of ICT in the classes.
let us talk about this student-centric learning approach. Okay, because whenever we talk about it, generally we do talk about the competency and outcome-based curricula. Again, the same question arises, that what exactly do we do in the class? Do we simply, you know, simplify the content which is there in the curriculum and share it with our students, or do we add on something from our end in the innovative point of view? That is always a question. I think most of us, I am not blaming, but most of us, what do? We try to simplify the thing in the class. Actually, that is not the purpose. If you use the ICT, you create your own. Suppose you are dealing with somebody teaching mathematics. You know, you waste half of your lecture on writing the things on the board. Why do you waste it? Instead of conducting one particular problem in the class, you can complete 2 to 3 problems in the class if you develop your own PowerPoint presentation. If you simply click once, one step will appear. Second click, second step will appear. Likewise, one after the other, number of clicks are required there to show your step, and automatically you can explain it, whereas you will be away from the dust of the chalk pieces. It will not disturb your entire body, and moreover, it will be very effectively presented in the classes. Those who are the teachers of science, sorry to say, but it is the situation almost in all colleges. The teachers of science hardly use ICT technology for effective teaching of the scientific components. Suppose I am talking about the developing a sapling. I am teaching botany, and I am talking about how does a sapling develops in the course of time. In one day it is sprouting, day two again it is developing. How does it happen? If I want to teach it, I think I can teach it more effectively if I show them a sort of video based on the same idea. When I am teaching electronic circuits, how does the electronic circuit functions? How does a mobile component, whatever hardware we have, how does it function? I am teaching in the classroom of an electronic subject. I think I should use technology. If I explain the theory, if I explain the practical, do they understand that? But when I show it on the screen, this is how it happens, this is how the circuit completes, then the action takes place, how the magnetic waves are converted to sound waves and vice versa. So this can be presented in the technological point of view with the help of ICT. But you know, we are not putting any efforts in this direction, and we are hardly using the ICT for the classroom, and that is how it is also affecting the competency level of the teacher as well as the competency level of the learner, because this is a vice versa effect that we always find. Similarly, moves towards problem-based learning, we should improve. This ICT can create this sort of platform. See, generally what we are doing, we are sharing, and I am telling the same thing again and again, I know that. But instead, we should be analytical, we should be interpretative, and we should make our learners learn how to solve the problems. Right? Whether they are the pedagogic issues, social issues, or the subject that you are teaching, they can be oriented to the subject also. But that sort of dissemination should take place in the class. Then increase the use of the web as an information source. Already I said, if you are doing research, please don't use general Google. But generally what is happening in the society? Most of us, including our children, all are using Google, sir. Whatever problem we have, earlier we used to approach the teacher. Now we are approaching
Google.
No. And we are doing a Google search. How far the information that you are getting is really reliable, that is always a question. So we should motivate our learners to use web resources for seeking information. But we should encourage them to have a correct search. Okay. So these techniques, if at all the teachers are, you know, giving them, it will be the increased way of seeking the sources of information with the help of the technology and the web information available over there. Users can also choose experts from whom they want to learn. Of course, teacher is always an expert. It is at least assumed that he is the epitome of knowledge or a source of inspiration or the source of knowledge, that kind of thing.
But parallelly, see that whether you are putting your computer, you are putting your laptop, you are putting your smartphone in association with the teacher, and that is also providing a kind of better platform for learning apart from the teacher's performance only. So here, competency and performance-based curricula we need to develop, because when you are talking about the student-centric learning, you should also talk about the competency-based curricula learning. Because I'll tell you one thing, why we are not using ICT? Can you tell me one simple answer for this? We are not using ICT. Why? You did not understand that? We are not using ICT, including me. Suppose we are not using ICT. Why? Because it is not the part and parcel of our curriculum development. What is happening in curriculum development? We enlist some topics, we enlist some prescribed books, and we enlist some suggested readings, some suggested reference books. Is there anything that you mention from YouTube, go for these videos, from Swayam, go for these video lectures, watch this Vyaskini, go for this thing? Is it suggested? And that is the reason the teachers are also not encouraged for using the ICT. So if at all those who are working as the members of the board of studies, is there anybody? Okay, very good. So you can do one thing. Whenever you go for the next year, whatever course you are developing or the curriculum you are developing, ensure that at least enlist a few things, just like the suggested reading. If you, motivate the teachers for that, automatically at least 5% of them, 10% of them, 20% of them will initiate in that direction, and some sort of thing will definitely happen. Okay, so this is how this curriculum development, the role of a teacher is also equally responsible for creating that sort of atmosphere as needed over there. So now you will talk about this. What are the tools that we use for ICT? There are a few common tools which are easily available in all institutions, whether it is a taluka place or a district place or a metropolitan, at least these tools are easily available. So I have a question. Like, I don't know whether all the colleges located in the rural area, they are really having these many facilities available. I have a doubt, because it depends on the temperament of the institution, management, sometimes the principal also to facilitate the teachers with this kind of gadget. But since all of us are undergoing for NAC, you may be the part and parcel of the NAC team, or else you are the you are getting the responsibility in the IQAC activities. Several criteria are there. If you see now, 70% of the assessment of the institution is going to be done ICT based. How many of you know about it? Everybody knows? 70% of the assessment is done by ICT based, online. And 30% is depending on cross verification. Whatever we claimed in our SSR, okay, IQARI, SSR, at the end, you will find that they will simply cross check. Suppose you claim that we have 3 virtual classrooms. Suppose you claim year 1, you install one, year 2, again you mentioned we have installed another, again in third year you installed third. So having 3 virtual classrooms in one college, that too located in a small taluka place, will always be a kind of small doubt in the mind of the assessor. So they will cross verify when they come for the visit. So let us look at your 3 virtual classrooms. But they don't only see the physical classroom, that you have a virtual board, you have all these elaborate infrastructure. They will ask you, can you please show me the utility? What is utility? How many classes are conducted here? Who are the teachers, those who conducted? What are the topics conducted? And the attendance of the students, those who attended the virtual class. So they will not ask you later. They will just see the information on a piece of paper. Later on, when they have the interaction with the students, they will identify how many of you attended the virtual classes. Nobody raised that. Then they understand what was going on. Correct? So they rely on the information that you provided. But they don't confirm the information from your end. They confirm the information from the other sources, that the student-centric approach, they focus on that. And that way you are caught over there, that you are doing some foolish thing over here. So this is how this ICT-based NAC assessment or NBA assessment. What is NBA? National Board of Accreditation. For all the technological institutions or technical subject institutions, NBA is done. And NAC is done for both technical and non-technical, both, not an issue at all. So here we need to understand that. So having LCD projector means this kind of thing, LCD or LED projector, okay. Now LCD has gone back, now this is LED, advanced technology we are using. Then you have to have a projection screen. You don't need a screen also. If you have a plain wall with a faint color, white color or cream color, it will work as a screen over there, not an issue. Then a computer just like this, one computer is provided,